Thank you so much for having me here. As David said, this was my entry for the SharePoint hackathon. And if you were not familiar with the hackathon itself, it had four main categories. And I submitted for all the four. I will not cover the agent because that was a low ball for me. It didn't worth showing it here, but I will show you what I did with SPFx, with the new layouts that allow you to build really nice pages, and also show you the Viva Connections dashboard that exists in the landing page. But to give you a bit more context of what we are about to see, let me go to the Explorer fictional presentation of the company that we will use for this demo. So I had to create a story to be able to create something nice and something that looks good, and I came up with this fictional company called Explorer. It is all about outdoors activities, and it has a custom font, custom colors, everything fully defined. So this was the base to create SharePoint site and all the branding. So these are the main colors and how the logos should be used in the intranet. These are the custom fonts that must be used everywhere inside of the intranet. For the headings, it's Alternox. Well, I love Segway UI, so it's the default font for the body, so it still looks like SharePoint at the end of the day. And that branding configuration was transformed into this. And what you see in the screenshot of this full page intranet page is a custom branding with custom fonts applied, with SPFx web parts, and an application customizer that it's actually not visible here, but I will show you how it looks and what it does. There's list formatting also visible in this page. Everything was built using flexible sections because these days I use flexible sections for everything. And there's quite a few section backgrounds mixed together with new and old standard web parts. So let's see how it looks like in my real environment. I will not go through the customization and the creation of the branding center and custom themes and uploading custom fonts and creating those custom branded themes to apply to your SharePoint, because I wouldn't have time to cover all of that. But I think David has a set of links prepared to share with all of you, so you can follow the process of creating the branding and uploading your fonts easily from those articles. So let's jump right into the intranet page. And what you can see over here is, well, this is the background image that was in the slide along with the logo. So it looks really cool. Then we have our first flexible section. And in this flexible section, there are actually three web parts. So the Good Afternoon, João, is a custom SPFx web part that I've been, it should have been in the repo for a long, long time. I promise that one of these days I will put it out there. I have it online on my blog, but I want to share it in the repo with all of you guys so you can play with it, modify it, and move it to the next level as the community always do. Then there's the tutorial card, the brand new web part. And what we have here is the image web part with a map that sits on top of the background to create this nice composition that exists in here. Then if we move down into the page, there's a new section, and I don't know if you can see it in the screen share, but there's also a background applied to this section. And again, everything was built with flexible sections. There are mountains in the background, and there's a communication hub. And this communication hub has text by part at the top to say to write the communication hub. What you see as an alert, it's actually a list formatting that gets the alerts from a SharePoint list and then displays them in here. And that overlaps with the SharePoint web part. And I'll show you in a minute with a page in edit mode why I'm overlapping all of this with the flexible sections. Then we have the dashboard from Viva Connections. Well, now you can put it everywhere, but it's always nice to have it in your pages. It gives you a nice way to access to other applications with the shortcuts or to easily access to more from your intranet directly on your phone or in your web page like this menu from the Explorer Cafe that it's available directly from here. I will not click in here, but you have to trust me that this redirects me to another page. Well, I can, I will not. Otherwise, we will lose a lot of time seeing, but that will redirect me to another page, to another SharePoint page where the description for that specific entry is inside of SharePoint. So this is the dashboard. A couple of things that I wanted to create into this dashboard. I want it to be dynamic, so it's not always static. And for that, there's this this holiday car that updates with the next holiday. There's quick links to open other apps, and there's obviously the more complete Explorer Cafe that it's also dynamic and it's updated every day. So it's guaranteed that when your user lands into your landing page, this section, it's always refreshed and has new content with SharePoint news, with new alerts or the lack of alerts if there's nothing to show, and with the updated dashboard. Continuing to go back here, I created another section, but this time without a background to just get the plain blank background from SharePoint. And this again has the custom fonts in the titles, and it's just the regular calendar or events web part along with quick links next to it. And at the bottom of the page, there's the team updates that were built with more flexible sections with custom backgrounds that create this nice effect. And what you see in here, it's a composition of multiple web parts that were grouped together and overlapped to create this. Instead of building a custom web part to look like exactly this, I reused and repurposed everything that Microsoft has now out of the box, created the template, and then replicated it for each one of the users. And what I was mentioning about the application customizer that goes with you to all the pages in the intranet is this Microsoft Teams integration. I already demoed that once in this call. I will not click here because this is my tenant and there's real data in there, but I'll show you this video. This is basically Microsoft Teams embedded in your SharePoint pages, and you are actually able to start a conversation or access to your list of chats directly from your SharePoint pages. And this one I already submitted to the community repo, so if you want to play with it, it's there for you to get access and play in, install it in your own tenant. So now let's see what we have here. This page is already in edit mode, isn't it? If it's not, it's supposed to be. Well, looks like it took too much time and it's no longer in edit mode, but let's close this. Let me quickly show you what we have here. So at the top, there's the custom web part that gets the good afternoon, good morning, good evening, followed by the name of the user that is actually in here, or it can display a custom message. This is a very basic version of the web part. It inherits the fonts that are actually applied to the site, but I want to create a new version that, well, eventually I will submit them to the repo that allows you to define the font, the color for the font, the font that is actually rendered there, and also the font size. But this is for now the version that I have, and I can select with full name, last name, or simply no name. And well, same thing with the messages. Then there's the journal card and the message. And here, this is plain and simple. There's it's just drag and drop web parts to this flexible section and put them out there, and you are good to go. Here is where things start to great. This didn't load one of the web parts. This is where I had to apply some tricks to get the desired behavior. So one of the things that I was looking for was getting the consistent front across all the web parts. And some of the out-of-the-box web parts do not inherit yet the custom font for the title. The Viva Connections dashboard is one of those web parts. So to fix that, what I had to do was to put here another web part on top that writes the name of the web part with a white image that covers the original dashboard title. So this way, and I'm breaking all of this, this way, instead of getting the out-of-the-box font family here, I was able to hide that with a white image, and then on top I've put the title using the title web part. If you ask me if this is the best possible idea for a landing page, well, probably not, because you will end up with a lot of web parts just to get the correct font. But well, I really wanted this to look good, so I threw all these web parts on top of each other to get a nice and consistent look across the board. Here, same thing. This is the list web part with the formatting applied to it. The SharePoint news web part also has a title, and there's no option to hide that title. So what I did was to overlap this web part on top of this one, so it's hiding the title. And if I over and click, you can see that this border actually shows the actual height of the web part, and the title, it's hidden behind the alerts. If the alert is not here, then we have a problem. But I'm controlling the demo, so this will always be here, and the title for the news web part is not in here. Well, here's nothing special to show, just two web parts in a flexible section. In here, there's a nice trick that you can use to create the separation, and this this one doesn't include depth because it doesn't have shadows, but you can create different depths in your page if you use something like this. I have this blue mountains here at the top of this section. This is just the background of the section, the title for the section. And then I have another section that actually gets the same color of this darker blue mountain. And when published, this seems all the same section, even though it's two different sections, and you can create really nice effects if you combine the backgrounds and the colors of the sections together. And again, here, what I told you, this is grouped, or it was supposed to be grouped. Right now it's not, but this is what I did. So to create this composition, each one of these cards has an image with a profile. There's another image that actually shows the pink color for the text to be placed on top. Then there's two text web parts, and this was replicated for all these ones. These ones are actually grouped. So if I want to copy this and replicate it to create another one, the only thing I had to do was to click copy, and here it is. The entire composition was copied over, and with this, I didn't have to develop a custom web part, and I can replicate this in the same page. The disadvantage of not having a custom web part is that I cannot move this to another page. But well, for the same page, it's just great to have the possibility to stack the web parts on top of each other, group them, copy, and done. It's ready to be reused. So this is what I did. For the landing page, I just saw a question about mobile. And if you ask about mobile, well, this is not ready for mobile. I would love to get the possibility to define the exact layout for tablet and for mobile devices. There's an option in the flexible zone to define the reflow, but this doesn't quite do it yet. And it will not look good in the majority of the scenarios and the majority of the things that I tried. I simply would love to get the possibility to define how things would look in a tablet view and in a mobile view as well. But well, hopefully we will get it one day. I don't know. But if you ask me, is this ready for mobile? Then the answer is no. All right, so this is what I did for the landing page, but I did a bit more to it. And I forgot to put my timer on. So David, if you can tell me if I still have time.
Yeah,
or
we're
not.
Pretty much, yeah, we're just right about out of time for this segment.
Okay, let me just show you another example that I will soon put in the repo. Actually, two examples to give a bit more to the pages in this section over here. It's not possible to add videos as a background of your sections, but you can use GIFs or GIFs and add a bit more of animation to the page, as I did in here with a plane flying from the US or Canada to Europe. And another thing that I want to show and share with you is how lists can be used in a SharePoint page in multiple ways. In this page that belongs to the same intranet, I have two features from the Microsoft lists embedded into the same page. So this is the lists form that embeds really well into a SharePoint page using the embed web part, along with a list formatting for a contact list that I will submit soon. Just need to finish some minor touches that allows you to combine internal users from your tenant with external people to the organization into the same list and then format it as a contact list. And well, this was my submission for the SharePoint hackathon. Hope you enjoyed. If you want to get in touch and know more about the specific details of what I did and how I deal with flexible sections, feel free to reach out. Here is the list of my contacts. The best place to find me these days is LinkedIn. So if you want to scan that QR code, you will go there directly. If you want to reach out on Twitter or Blue Sky, I'm also there. Email is also a valid thing. So thank you so much. And again, thank you for having me in one of these calls. Back to you, David.
Very, very cool. Thanks, Yao. Very, very cool. Really love all this. It's showcased. Really beautiful. I said it on other calls, but I feel like we're entering the phase of, can you make it look more like SharePoint instead of, can you make SharePoint not look like SharePoint? This is now becoming the showcase. So excellent job.